Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to export a Gantt chart to PDF and Excel document formats in a React application. I will also show you how to customize the documents and export them. If you have not watched my previous video on how to get started with a React Gantt chart, please do so. The video link is in the card above and the description below. I begin by opening the same application, where I have already installed the React Gantt package and configured all the modules of Gantt chart. Let me run this application now. See here the left pane as a tree grid and the right pane as a chart with project timeline. First, I'll show you how to enable PDF exporting in the Gantt chart component. I need to enable the toolbar to show the PDF export option. So, import the toolbar module and inject it into the Gantt chart services. Then assign the PDF export option to the toolbar property of the Gantt chart. As you can see, the Gantt chart is rendered with a toolbar and as a PDF export option. To perform PDF export, I need to import the PDF export module from the EG2 React Gantt package and inject it into the Gantt chart services. Then I include the allow PDF export property and set its value to true. When I click this PDF export button, the Gantt chart should be exported to PDF. To achieve this, I include the toolbar click event, which will be triggered whenever the toolbar item is clicked. Then I assign the toolbar button click callback method. I can export PDF document using PDF export built-in method. I'm adding a reference to the Gantt chart to call its built-in method. I declare the variable to get the instance and add the ref property in Gantt chart. In this method, I check whether the item ID contains PDF export and call the built-in method PDF export from the Gantt chart component to convert the tree grid records and chart into a PDF document. See here, when I click the PDF export option in the toolbar, the Gantt chart records will be exported into a PDF document. Now I will show you how to change the file name of the PDF document. Within the PDF export method, I include the file name option and assign a value project data. Check now. The PDF file is exported with a file name project data. I can also customize the look of the PDF document to be exported. By default, the page number is generated in the footer of the PDF document. I can enable or disable the footer using the enable footer property. For now, I set its value to false. As you can see, the exported PDF document does not have a footer. I can also remove the predecessor in the exported PDF document. I include the show predecessor lines property and set its value to false. See here, the predecessor is removed in the exported PDF document. Next, I will show you how to apply a theme to the Gantt chart PDF document using the theme property. The available built-in themes are Material, Fabric, Bootstrap, and Bootstrap 4. I assign the Fabric theme. Look here, the Fabric theme is applied to the PDF file. Next, I will show you how to customize the theme for Gantt chart in the exported PDF document. There are multiple options available to customize the theme style, and you can explore them in the document provided in the below description. First, I will show you how to customize the background colors in the taskbar and progress bar. It can be changed using the Gantt style in PDF export properties. To change the PDF file colors, I need to import the PDF colors from EG2 PDF export package. I change the task color, task border color, and progress color. Check the exported PDF document. The provided taskbar and progress bar colors are applied. Next, I will show you how to export Gantt chart to an Excel document. Just like with a PDF export, I need to import Excel export from the EJ2 React Gantt package and inject the module into Gantt services. I add the allow Excel export property and set its value to true. Then I include the Excel export and CSV export options in the toolbar. Check now, the Excel export and CSV export options are shown on the toolbar. As you know, when I click this button, the toolbar button click method will be called. So in this method, I check whether the item ID contains Excel export, and I use the Excel export built-in method from the Gantt chart to perform the export action. If the item is CSV export, then I use the CSV export built-in method. Now, when I click the Excel export toolbar option, the Gantt chart records will be exported to an Excel document. As I said, the Excel file will only contain records. Charts cannot be exported to Excel. If you click the CSV export option, the Excel document will be generated in the CSV format. Just like with PDF export, I can customize the document being exported to Excel. Using the file name option in the Excel export method, I specify the file name of the document to be saved. As you can see, when I click the Excel export toolbar button, the Excel file will be generated with the specified name. To add a header and footer to the Excel document being exported, I need to add them as a rows and cells. I add header and footer options. In header, I add a single header row by assigning the header rows option to 1. In the rows property, I add a cell with a column span of 4 and the value of project time tracking report. Then I add styles to change the font size and row alignment. Similarly, you can add the footer using the footer options. As you can see, in the Excel document, you will find the header and footer. Now, to change the theme of the exported Excel document, I will include the theme property and specify the font color option for the header and record. Look here. The provided font color is applied to the header and records. Here is a quick recap of what we have seen so far. I showed you how to export Gantt chart to PDF and Excel file format. I also showed you how to customize the documents to be exported. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you are eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.